Facebook. Hope you're doing awesome. Happy Monday to you. And it is a beautiful Monday, I'll just tell you. I actually had to peel off some layers. I had a hat. I went out way overprepared. I guess it's better to be overprepared than to be underprepared. And that's what I want to share with you. By the way, on a side note, I am the creator of the Lean Body Breakthrough. I help coach busy moms and dads over 40 who want to lose weight, want to get that weight off, not just get the weight off, but keep it off forever. And they want to do it without long workouts or impossible diets. So if that's something you're interested in, go ahead, hit me up with a message and we'll talk about it. We'll get on a quick call. But I want to share with you really, first and foremost, if you're struggling to lose weight, I'm going to give you really something that'll be really, really helpful. It's something I see people struggle with all the time. It's that, especially on Monday when it's time to jump on the scale and, you know, do the deed of either being excited with that scale saying or disappointed in the things that you did over the weekend maybe or in the past week or maybe the past 2 months. But really two things you have as far as options. You have the option to react to what that scale says, or you have the option to respond to what the scale says. Now there's two differences. There's differences in those, more than one. But I want to share with you really the difference between reacting, you know, and I know a lot of people will react. They'll get upset like, oh, I did so well for January. I was so inspired and motivated and I'm just not motivated anymore. Or, you know, you got the weight off. You got 10 pounds off maybe or 20 pounds off. And then now it's March and the weight's starting to creep back on. And you're frustrated and disappointed with yourself. And that's a reaction, right? You're gonna start having these feelings of being defeated, you know, being just upset, mad at yourself. That quick fix, you know, is not working anymore. You went on that crash diet, you took those pills, you did the cleanse. You know, you started off strong in the gym, maybe worked out 3 or 4 times a week for the past month, month and a half, and then February got a little away from you. We're in March now, right? We're in the third month. We're getting to the end of the first quarter, right? That's kind of crazy to believe. But back to what will be helpful right now is to choose whether or not you're going to react to it or respond. Now, how do you react? Like I just said, your feelings take over. You get upset with yourself. You feel like a failure. You say, I'm never going to get the weight off. I'm just going to give up. Why bother? It doesn't work. This doesn't work for me. I just can't lose weight. I just can't get in shape. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. And I'm not going to talk about all the reasons what maybe you're doing right and wrong. I want to just share with you something that might be insightful for you starting out your week, because you could either do that, choose that direction, is to react. And it goes to say the same if you're having great success and you react and you're all excited about losing weight. Maybe you lost 5 pounds last week or last month or 10 pounds or more. And the reaction is, woohoo, yeah, I did it. I'm there. I made it. And then you know what happens? I see it all the time, is that you start to slack off. You start to put your priorities on the side burner. You say, you know what? I can have that second or third glass of wine because I lost the weight. And you know what? I can just do it again if I need to. Or you don't really think about that. You're just thinking about feeling excited because you fit in that dress or that outfit that you haven't been able to fit in. And you know what? You're going to go out and then you're going to blow it out of the water and ruin all the results you did in the past month or 2 months in a matter of a couple of weeks. And I don't think you want to go that direction either. In fact, it's one of the things we address in my Lean Body Breakthrough coaching program, is building the habits that you can enjoy the weekends and enjoy your time and enjoy a glass of wine or two and have the flexibility that you need in your day. Again, I really don't want to get into too much of that. The other option, however, and this is what I want to really focus on, is you have the option to respond. And here's the deal. There's really two ways to respond. You can respond by doing the same thing you did before. Maybe you had no structure, no plan. You just kind of winged it. And maybe you even got results. But because you winged it, you didn't really build any habits. You didn't build any structure. You don't have any accountability. And despite even getting some of those results, you find yourself right back where you started. Well, there's a response there, and looking at what you did before, maybe that's not the solution. Maybe that was, again, the quick fix that provided you with a little bit of weight loss, right? And then there's the other kind of response, is the choice to do something different. Now, this could be the week, this could be the month, this could be the first month in a very long time, maybe for the first time ever, you choose a different direction. And I'm not just saying get on board with my coaching program. In fact, my coaching program isn't the right fit for everyone. It isn't. In fact, I really specifically work with motivated parents who are tired of the quick fixes, tired of going up and down in the way, tired of, you know, the broken promises and things. And that's not what I offer. In fact, I offer a simple solution, something I've been working on for the past 25 years, working with clients in their 40s and older. And now I really just specifically work with busy moms and dads who are motivated and inspired to make the changes that they need. So again, regardless of that be with me, or you choose a different response, is really try to do something different. Try to find the solution that's going to work best for you. Now, the only way to do that is to evaluate and look at how you responded before, what didn't work. Now, if things are working, awesome. Like, keep doing it. But if you know it's not healthy, if you know you're losing weight and you know your body is going to hell in a handbasket, yes, I just said that. old school, right? But if your body is going downhill and it's going downhill quick, if you're like me in your later 40s, but you're stuck going up and down that cycle, it's probably time to stop reacting. In fact, it's the worst thing you can do, because what happens is then you get the mindset of saying, I'm a failure, I can't do this, I'm not good enough, I'm not valuable, I've tried all of the things. Well, first off, you probably haven't tried all of the things. And in fact, that's what I find people that tend to react too much tend to give up too much as well. And the only way you're going to get through this is to find the help that you need, whether it be with a coach. And hey, I make it really easy. I make it, there's no hard sales or pressure. You get on a quick call with me. I find out where you're at. I find out what you're trying to achieve. And then I see where you're struggling the most, where your obstacles are. And if I feel my program's a good fit, like I said, it's not a good fit for everyone, but it is a good fit for those busy parents over 40 who are limited on time, who are tired of diets, tired of extreme measures to get the weight off, want something sustainable, flexible, something that can work in their lifestyle, work around their family, around their travel plans, have a coach that they can go to and rely on and can be accountable to. It pretty much sounds like the solution, right? So if you're like, you know what, that sounds really good, the next question I always get, hands down, how much does it cost? Well, again, is it cheap? No, it's not cheap. But here's the deal. What you've been doing, chances are, if you're that struggling parent, if you've been struggling over the years, chances are you probably invested way more time, way more money. You probably invested, and you hopefully haven't really had to invest in counselors, but you may even need a counselor to fix up here. And I can tell you, it is hard. It's truly hard. Losing weight and getting in shape is not any easy task, by no means. But I would say is it's much easier when you have a coach who's in your corner. That's worth the investment. I don't care if it's $1 million. You're like, oh, I don't have $1 million, but I'm sure you probably have some sort of financial resources to invest in yourself. The thing is, we invest in the things that matter to us, right? So if you drive away in your $50,000 car and you say, you know what, I can't invest a few thousand bucks in a coach, then that's your choice. That's cool. And just enjoy that car, that's fine. Or a vacation, or fancy shoes that cost $300, that's cool, that's your prerogative. But I can tell you, if you're coming on to another month and you're reacting to what that scale says, and you're reacting to what your body is telling you and your mind's telling you, and you can't stand the way you look in front of the mirror, it's maybe time to start responding in a different manner. It's maybe time for you to choose a different path. Now, I'm not saying that path has to be with me, but it may be time that you really honestly take a hard look and respond in a way that's going to give you the results that you want, not just temporarily, but something that you can take with you and last with you forever. I'm just going to put the vision out there. This is what I'm going to finish with. Here's the thing that I like to share with my clients, getting them off their minds on the scale and what the scale says, and dictating how what they're worth based on what the scale says, and if they're overweight or fat or whatever, or all those words that people use when people aren't healthy, right? Think of the vision for your life after. Think of what could happen in 6 months, in a year, if you actually got the help you needed, if you had the weight off, if you have 50 pounds on your body, heck, if you have 10 or 20 pounds and it's limiting you from being your best, if you're like stressed out of your mind, you don't have the energy to last through the day. You're having crappy sleep habits. You see your kids that are looking at you eating garbage and drinking on the weekends and binging and doing all those things, and you're not a good example. Think of the potential for what could happen if you make that shift and you respond in a different way. Think of what could happen to not only your health, but the people in your life, the relationships, maybe even your job, maybe even your body that you feel is breaking down. But the reality is, it's because you have done nothing to keep it from breaking down. So I may be on a bit of a rant now, but I get excited, I get inspired. But here's the thing, why I get so inspired on Mondays, and I hope this message got you inspired as well, is that I have people in my world, in my coaching program, that are responding. They responded a different way. They're feeling better about themselves. They're losing the weight. They're building the habits. They're going on the vacations, enjoying life to the fullest. They're becoming a good example for their children. They're becoming a good example for the people in their neighborhood, their relationships that they have, their spouse. Can you imagine for a moment what it would be, if you struggle now with your weight and you struggle looking in the mirror, can you imagine what it would be like? Just picture this for a minute. Close your eyes and picture this for a minute. Can you imagine if you've hated taking your clothes off in front of your spouse for the past 5, 10, 20 years, and maybe you want the lights off when you become intimate? Hey, I'm gonna go there because I think it's important. Can you imagine what it would be like to take your clothes off in front of your spouse and be proud of the way you look and the way you feel and the intimacy that you can have with your spouse because you feel good about yourself? How valuable is that? That's invaluable, right? I've been married for 17 years, and I'll tell you one of the things, and I'm not going there, but I'm gonna tell you one of the things that I am so grateful for my wife. I'm so grateful that she is choosing to take good care of her personal health for 1,000 different reasons, but just selfishly as her husband, that we are so attracted to each other, more so now, I say, at least I'll say for me, more so now than I've ever been ever before, and I've been married for the past 17 years. And you were like, huh, what? Yes, it's true, I'm not blowing smoke, but I can tell you my wife works her butt off. It's not like it's just easy. It's not like I can wake up and do 4 sit-ups and have 6-pack abs. In fact, I've really never had 6-pack abs in my entire life. But I worked hard at maintaining the best health I can, and that takes effort. That takes responding in a way. It takes getting out of reactionary mode. And I've been there, trust me, in the past years. I've been in reactionary mode many times, not just with my health. But if you need a source of encouragement and something different, you need to respond in a different way, hit me up with a message. Shoot me a quick message. We'll get on a quick call. We'll talk about what that might look like for you. And listen, if my coaching program does not work for you, I'll point you in the direction that will. I've been doing this for 25 years. I've worked in everywhere, every areas from personal training to corporate fitness to physical therapy. I've owned a gym before. I've been there, done that. I don't have all the answers, but certainly if I don't have the answer for you in my coaching program, I can definitely point you in the right direction of one. But it's gonna require an investment, right? You're gonna say, I got a book of time. All you have to do is send me a quick message, book a time. We'll get on a quick call. I got a little bit of time this week before spring break next week when the kids get out of school, right? You gotta make time for the family, right? I'll tell you what, when you see what we're doing next week, and you'll realize the freedom that it is for a 47-year-old to my wife and I, 46 and 47, to be able to go and do a kind of trip that we're doing and be active and fit and do the things that we want to do, you'll get excited, trust me. And if you're not there, don't feel like bad about it. Do something about it. Respond in a way that's going to make a difference in your life. That's all I got. I hope you had an amazing, amazing weekend. I wish you all of the best for the upcoming week. I hope you respond in a way and not react to what that scale says. All right, take care. God bless.